From the time I was a baby, my grandma and Aunt Vina repeatedly informed me, "You've been born with the calling on your life, Ronnie Lee." I was just becoming aware of what that prophecy meant, how being chosen for a ministry made me different from everyone else. According to this message from the Holiest of Holies, I was to sacrifice the playthings of the world in order to fulfill the plans of God. Throughout the course of my religious training, I encountered many great prophets, faith healers, mystics, and savers of souls. In church, I would close my eyes and absorb the rambling vibrations given off from the gift of tongues, mixed in with sounds of foot stomping and bodies hitting the floor hard as they went out in the spirit. I would listen intently as people testified of physical healings, the exorcism of demons, and the detailed arrival of Armageddon. My childhood was spent among adults who believed that their lives read like the book of Job. It mystified me that as a mere test of faith, God unleashed hideous diseases and allowed actual demon possession. Later, the diseases could be removed, provided a powerful reverend minister executed the laying on of hands. The rarest and least talked about miracle is stigmata, wherein the gifted would spontaneously bleed from the same parts of the body that Christ bled. Because the only two living examples with stigmata were women, there seemed to be some indication that women were more open to receiving the gift. But I believed with all my heart it could be given to me. One day, Aunt Vina received a promotional flyer announcing, "Sister Linda's miraculous gift of stigmata, a 3-day visit to the Indio area." It described how sometimes she bled pure blood, and other times she bled a clear, scented healing oil. Putting the sweetest, holiest look on my face, I expressed my interest in attending. "Aunt Vina, I want to see this miracle." So my family drove into the desert to let me witness Linda bleed. That first night, after sitting through an uninspiring sermon delivered by the local Pentecostal minister, it became apparent that Linda was not going to bleed. I was disappointed, but anxious to return. On the second visit, the air was so still outside, I just knew she was going to bleed that night. Sister Linda had dark circles under her eyes, and her face was shiny with sweat. She sure looked like she had the Holy Spirit rattling around inside of her. I joined in a hymn singing, the chorus of twangy voices belting out, "When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout victory." Again, the minister tried for, but did not achieve, inspiration. Towards the end of the service, when she still had not bled. I wanted to have a temper tantrum. I thought, she's just a big fat fake. I couldn't understand why everyone else was so patient with waiting for her gift to reveal itself. All she had shown us were pictures of her previous bleedings, as if that were sufficient evidence of a miracle. She also told the congregation that impressions in blood would appear in her Bible. But I didn't want to hear stories of psychic phenomena. I wanted her to bleed. I'd gone there with a desire to be anointed in the blood seeping directly from her palms. I wondered if she would bleed from the place where the spear had been inserted in Christ's side. I pondered on whether or not she'd expose the side hole. Would she be modest, like my Aunt Vina? Or was a stigmata wound different? I imagined what the blood would look like, running down her forehead, seeping through her clothes. But she hadn't bled from anywhere on those two nights.